Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the higher, everybody. Praise the higher. One more time, praise the higher from whom all blessings flow. Amen and amen. This is your sister Carrie Ann, Yesiah the Christ, Yesiah the Messiah, Yesiah of Nazareth. If you want to know why I call God the higher and the Bible called Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Yesiah, I've done a video concerning that one. Greetings to the 12 scattered tribe of Yashahel. Yashahel is the name given to Jacob. Jacob's name was not changed to Israel. The proper name is Yashahel. So I greet all the Hebrew Yashahelites scattered to the four corners, hallelujah, of the earth, all over in the so-called diaspora that the wicked has given us, all over the world. Amen. I greet you all in the glorious, precious name of our soon coming King, Yesiah the Christ, and to the beautiful body of Christ, the church. I greet you all in the glorious name of our precious King, Yesiah. All right, you can skip this bit and find the main message. All right, find the main message. I'm going to do some housekeeping. Remember, my name is Sister Carrie Ann, solid gray border with a tick. Anybody else in the comment section pretending to be me, though they're using my profile picture, if it's not solid gray border, my name and a tick, it's not me. Rebuke and report them. All right, continue to watch the video, like the video, subscribe to the channel, brothers and sisters, so that you know you don't miss out on end time prophecies. I know that some of you are not subscribed because that's your thing, isn't it? But as I suppose, as long as you know to come on here and check when I post stuff, it'd be great. All right, and in the comment section, continue to write your comments. Let's fellowship together. I know sometimes I don't have the time to go down and like and communicate, but nevertheless I do go in sometime and read the comments when I can. All right, hallelujah to the Most High. All right, top 20, I will say that at the end of the video, and watch the video to the end. There's a sinner's prayer there for you. Thank you for those of you who have blessed me through PayPal. It's been a bread for me. I really appreciate it. Thank you. All right. We are near. We're not only near to the returning of the beautiful Messiah, but we're also near to the revealing of the dirty Antichrist and the lawlessness. All right. Daniel chapter 7 verse 25 tells you that Satan is going to give the Antichrist power to change times, laws and seasons. Brothers and sisters, that world is going to be demonic. It's going to be like Mad Max, aka the Book of Eli, that type of post-apocalyptic, wicked, dirty world. You want to make sure that your anchor holds in Christ. Really and truly, you want to make sure that you make it into the second Exodus. Second Exodus is coming up. It is real. It is biblical. It will happen before sixth seal. The second Exodus, aka going into the wilderness for safety, will happen before the sixth seal. And we know what the second Exodus is about. It's about regathering of our highest people, the seed of Ahiah. Amen. Out of this wicked world, because he promised Father Abraham that he will regather his children. And so that is going to happen before sixth seal opens. So you have to make sure you're really, you're in that, on them ships. Cruise liners. Cruise liners. Hallelujah. Glory be to your name, Lord. All right. We have a prophetic theme song called We Are Near. It's a song that my mommy taught me when I was a little girl. She said, I had sweeties and toys and we were near to the stuff. She used to sing How Near You Are. And the song goes like this. How near you are, oh near you are, oh near you are, oh near. How near you are, oh near you are. Oh, now you are, oh, now. Hallelujah. Yes, we are near and we can sing that song with red confidence. Okay, brothers and sisters, listen. I feel like I have to say this at every video now. I have two ministries. One, I am an end time prophetess to the whole entire world. Doesn't matter who you are. Whole world. I'm an end time prophetess where I talk about the mark of the beast, the crashing of the economy, the revealing of the dirty Antichrist and who he is, storm, tsunami, fallen angel, those type of end time, you know, apocalyptic event that's going to happen. That's my first ministry. But then I've got a second ministry, which I'm called to the nation. I'm called to the Hebrew Yeshahelites. So sometimes when I talk about Hebrew Yeshahelites or things pertaining to ancient Yashahel in, you know, 2020, the 12 scattered tribe. Some people may not understand. I understand that. I do understand. So just listen to what I have to say. You may not understand it, but those who are awakened and into the truth of understanding who the true Jews, put it that way, who they are, will understand when I come with a message for the Hebrew Yeshahelites scattered in 2022. All right. So yesterday, the 31st. Yes. The 31st, I released a video concerning a Babylon, US basketballer called Kyrie Irving. Many brothers and sisters on this channel know who I were talking about. Now, quick synopsis: I've never ever in my whole entire life heard about this man, never, until about 3 days ago, when he posts something on his Twitter and everybody's saying he's been anti-Semitic. All right, post something concerning about the Hebrews to Negro video documentary, and they didn't like it. You know the story. I did an interview and they were asking him questions about it, and that's that. Anyway, I did that video yesterday, and when I did the video, what was the video about? I forgot. It was yesterday. So I did that video. Oh yes, thank you Lord. I did that video basically telling the brothers and sisters, you need to pray for the guy, for this Kyrie Irving. He really, really needs prayer, because the enemy is after him. They're setting up traps for him, where I saw in the realm of the spirit, where I saw four guys going in to hurt him. They didn't hurt him. They couldn't do it because Ahaya had protected him. Amen. And that was that. That was what the video was all about. All right. Mostly. Okay. Why am I back here today talking about Kyrie? Why? Because in my mind, I released what the Most High told me to release concerning him. He gave me the vision, and I gave it to the church, for the church to pray for him. So here I am on the 1st of November, 2022. Yes, the video is about Kyrie Irving. Why am I back here talking about this man? This morning, around about 7 o'clock, I had two revelations. One about Kyrie and one about Elon Musk, which I will do a video, separate video for Elon Musk at some point. So, the Lord gave me a revelation about Kyrie Irving. Kyrie. Good old Kyrie Irving. This morning, I heard in my spirit very, very clearly. I heard Kyrie Irving is Aaron. Hear what I say, brothers and sisters. Kyrie Irving is Aaron, like the ancient Hebrew Yeshahelite Aaron, like Moses Aaron brothers. Brothers and Aaron were brothers. I heard in my spirit, Kyrie Irving, Aaron. And I said, Aaron? I said, okay. And the Lord began to speak to me, because I began to question the Lord. And I said, Father, what do you mean, Aaron? What do you mean, Kyrie Irving, Aaron? And I heard in my spirit that Kyrie Irving and Black Moses, you know who I call Black Moses? Yay. They're going to work very, very close together. Their leadership, especially for the African Americans, are going to be next to none. And people are going to think that they're Aaron and Moses. I never lie. I cannot lie. He cannot lie, brothers and sisters. I came up with a prophecy and I told you that yay, aka Kanye West, yeah, he is Black Moses. Now, let me quickly put a little snip on this, because in the comment section, people are saying, why do you say Black Moses? Haven't Moses always been black? Why do you call him Black Moses? Black Moses is just an emphasizing. It's just emphasizing that ancient Hebrew Yashahelite Moses was of a man of color. So that's the reason why for it. This is not about white or Chinese or whatever. It's just emphasizing That's all it is. All right? Okay. I heard Aaron. So this Kyrie guy, you have to pay close attention to him, brother, especially the African Americans. You have to pay close attention to this Kyrie person. This basketball guy, pay very, very close attention to him, because a high is going to rise him up. He's going to be raised up for a time and a season for his people. I understand in the comment section, brothers and sisters, because I don't follow them. I don't need to follow. I don't, really and truly, because I really get my information from the Holy Ghost, and sometimes it filters through brothers and sisters who, you know, will, you know, watch basketball and understand, love their we call them sportsmen, so to speak. All right, so understand why people follow Kyrie, but I'm not into basketball and stuff like that. But anyways, you have to pay, especially African Americans, you have to pay close attention. I would say right now, in terms of the natural, what's going on, pay attention to Black Moses and Kyrie. Now, few brothers and sisters in the comment section on the video says, "Oh, Sister Karen has removed this tweet concerning Hebrews to Negro." I don't know. I don't know true, because I don't really follow them up. But if you go in the comment section underneath that video, pray for Kyrie. In the comment section, brothers and sisters are saying, "Oh, this is removed his tweet concerning the Hebrew to Negro video." It's not a big deal, really and truly. It's not going to change who he is. It's not going to change. Removing that video from his Twitter account or what Twitter feed, it's no big deal. It's not going to change who he is. It still holds the truth. And the thing about it is that he's going to come out with more truth. He's going to come out with more truth and deeper truth when the Most High begin to use him. Now, he is not in the position of Aaron now, but he's getting there. He's not in the position of Aaron as we speak, but this is the position that the Most High is leading him into. Now, Black Moses and Aaron, aka Kyrie, is not to be worshipped. So don't go up seeing them on TV or wherever and begin to know their leaders. You worship Ahiah through his son, Yesiah. That's it. These are just two leaders that the Most High is going to use really, really strongly, especially for the African Americans. I'm going to use them. All right? I want to show you something. Now, I watched the interview because I said the beloved in the Most High, one of my brother called Torch Bearer, big up yourself, Torch, all right, sent me something, the interview that he did when the reporters were questioning him, why have you put up the anti-Semitic Hebrew to whatever, if Hebrew to Negroes, it's, you know, it's really, really bad and all that. And he did the interview and he handled it really well. And I said in the interview, when I was watching it, I went into a trance. That's why I did that video, Pray for Kyrie. Because when he said that, I want to go home to my wife and my kid, wrap up this interview, that's when the Most High gave me a vision about him. Don't ask me how the interview ended, because I don't know. I have no idea. Because I came off when I went into the trance. All right? The Lord said to pray for him. But watch this. I went back just now because I know I'm going to do a video about Aaron, a.k.a. Kyrie. All right? I went back because the Most High began to show me something about how this guy was dressed in the interview. All right? I'll show it to you first. Well, my iPad is not that dirty. Alright, so this is him. Okay, alright. Can you see this ring light? I don't know these dirty ring lights, honestly. Alright, so that's the guy, right? That's Kyrie. And those of you watching the interview, Most I begin to point out to me how he was dressed. And I know that some of, you know, some people, when they do their interview, they put the hoodie on or whatever. But this is different. This is by design. This is by design. He's got the hoodie on his head. I'll show it to you again. You can go and look for the interview. Watch it. All right? He's got the hoodie on. Okay, this is Aaron. All right, Aaron. Okay, he's got the hoodie on. Very significant. And you might say, oh, Sister Karen, well, they all wear the hoodie when they're doing. I know that. But this is symbolic. This is symbolic, brothers and sisters. Watch this. I'm going to show you something else again. You see that? What's that? Yes. Listen, I don't look at things natural. I always look at things spiritual. Always, always, always. So I saw that. You see that yes beside Aaron? Yes. Yes to everything. Yes to your way. Yes to your will. Yes to your majesty. Hallelujah. Yes. All right. And it's not only one yes. Look at that. Confirmation. You got double yeses. Come on, old church. See that? Two yeses. Where's my other yes? See the two yeses? At Kyrie. Aaron, aka Aaron. Hope you can see. Ring light. All right. Watch this now. So I saw these things. I said, okay. Remember, I just went back today. All right. I didn't see this when I watched the interview because I went into a trance. But just before I did the video, the Lord said, go back and look. I want to show you something. And this is what the Most High is showing me in the spirit. See all those yeses? Confirmation for who he is. Aaron. Watch this. Show you something again. Look at this. You see, come on, don't spin on me. You see the color? What color is he? Oh, this ring light is in my way. All right. Can you see Aaron? What color is he wearing? What color is that? Look at him. What color is it? Yeah. Sackcloth color. Brown. Everything, the way he dressed, everything about him in this interview, it's not by luck, it's not coincidence or anything. No, this is by design. This is what Ahiah told him to wear. Sackcloth color, this young man is wearing, Aaron. Sackcloth color, brothers and sisters. He's telling you who he is. This guy's fully awake. He's not just tiny bit awake. No, he's completely. The truth that's inside of him. Listen to me. Call him Aaron. When Aaron comes on the scene, I mean, he's on the scene already for the basketball thing. But when he begins to work for the Most Higher and he begins to spit truth, African Americans are going to wake up. He's going to link up with Black Moses. So, here you have it. The Lord said the color that he's wearing is sackcloth. Sackcloth color. Which means judgment. This is a color of judgment. We know that red is a color, but this color that this young man is wearing, Kyrie, aka Aaron, it's a judgment color, brothers and sisters. Judgment color. Mighty God, I create. It's a nice time to be alive, honestly. The Lord is just going to work. The way the Most High is going to work is just going to be amazing. Absolutely amazing. So, Ahiah don't have to make new things because he's already established certain things. And when the Lord says to me, Ahiah says to me, yea, it's Black Moses. I said, Black Moses. I said, Black Moses. You know you've got Aaron. Obviously, they're not the ancient Hebrew, Yashahelite, Moses from back in the days, but they're a type. Just like John the Baptist was a type of Elijah. Kyrie Irving is a type of Aaron. He's going to manifest in that, the work that Aaron used to do. got to read your Bible and study Aaron and see what Aaron used to do. And then obviously Black Moses, aka Yeh, is going to operate in the type of things that Moses, ancient Hebrew, Yashahela, these two men are Hebrews, they're Yashahels. Moses, Yeh, and Kyrie, but they know it anyway, so I don't really have to say it, but just in case people don't know, they are Hebrews or Hebrew brothers, Yeshahelites, Yeshahels. And so the Most High chosen them. You know, people say to me, and my mom said it to me as well. She said, oh, and she's talking to me, she said, oh, she said, I think, you know, I said, I think you're like Deborah. She said, I think you're like the prophetess Deborah, ancient, the judge over Yeshahel. And I don't know about that. I said, Mom, I'm not getting ahead of myself, really and truly. I don't know about Deborah. But I understand what she's saying. It's a spirit. It's like, it's operating in the spirit, you know, of Deborah. I'm no means Deborah at all. Could never walk in that prophetess shoes because she was absolutely amazing. I couldn't do what she do, but I'm grateful for what I'm doing for the Most High in 2022. But it's just some of the attributes, I suppose. So like with Kyrie and Yeh, they're operating in the spirit. One is operating in the spirit of Aaron and the next in Moses. So I call Yeh Black Moses and Kyrie Aaron, because that's who they are. Now, I want to clarify something, because I know some of you brothers and sisters, because you obviously follow them, and you're going to go off in my head. In that same comment section, there was a sister who posted something. She posted a comment and she went, Sister Carrie-Anne, I don't know about Kyrie, really. Because she said there's some stuff on his Twitter or Instagram that promotes ancestry. I don't know. What you've got to understand that though they fall short of the grace of the Most High, when they fully come into the truth, certain wayward belief will fall away. It will. Black Moses, Yeh, and Aaron, Kyrie, is going to complete what Malcolm X have started. Malcolm X has started a movement in terms of trying to wake up the people, getting the people together. I'm not talking about his religion. I'm not talking about Malcolm X. Was it Islam? I think it was Islam, isn't it? I think it was Islam. Let me just quickly check, brothers and sisters. But it's not about the religion part. It's like when I say it in the prophecy. I gave the prophecy, didn't I? And I say that Louis Farrakhan and Kanye, oh well, Yeh, aka Black Moses, is going to work. I see them standing together. And people are saying, oh, Louis Farrakhan is a Muslim. How is that going to work? I'm not talking about the religion. This is what people get mixed up. It's not about the religion. I'm talking about as a people who we are. As a nation, Hebrew, Yashahels, waking up, or aka the Jews, or the true Jews. I'm not talking about Islam or Christianity and all of that. No. Because that's not what I saw. I saw as if the knowledge in terms of what Louis Farrakhan have, the knowledge that he has concerning the true Jews, who are the people. I'm not talking about Islam and Allah and no, not that. Because we know the truth. We know that Yeshua is the truth. He is the way, he is the life. You cannot go to heaven without Yeshua. You have to have him first. Amen. I'm not talking about the Islamic part. I'm talking about who the people are as they call them Jews, as Hebrews. You have to know who you are. So I believe that Farrakhan is gonna I don't know, somehow help him, or not help, but impart some form of truth. Because, you know, he's got some truth there as far as concerning who the true people are. Impart some form of truth to Black Moses. So that's why maybe I saw them standing together. Not that Black Moses is going to turn and become a Muslim. No, 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 no. He ain't. Never, never, ever, ever, ever. In fact, what I saw as I was giving that prophecy and I didn't speak with Louis Farrakhan and Black Moses standing together. In fact, Black Moses is going to win over a whole bunch of those Muslims that's underneath Farrakhan's leadership. They're gonna turn, they're gonna come to Christ through Black, they're gonna come to Christ. Black Moses is gonna wake them up. They're gonna see the truth. Because you see, one of the problem why Black people turn to Muslims is because of this white Jesus business. Like, no. And then saying that, you know, God has no son. So it's just those awkward non-truth that turn our people into something else. But when they get the truth, they will turn back. And listen, don't rule out Farrakhan, because he might just come up one day and just apologize to the people and say, you know what, I got it wrong. I was a Muslim for so many years, but I got it wrong. Yesaya is the son of Ahaya, I believe. Glory be to your name, Lord. So don't rule him out. All right? If Ahaya can touch Yeh and turn him into Black Moses, what do you think about Farrakhan? He can do anything. Especially if they belong into the kingdom of Ahaya. Because many of these people are running around. But their names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. They just don't know it, and they're just operating in a wicked spirit. But when the spirit of truth comes to them, they'll change. And they begin to acknowledge who Yesaya is. So it's not about religion. It's not about that. It's about awakening who the true Jews are. So now you're going to have a battle, isn't it? You're going to have a massive battle in the world. Who are the true Jews? Is it the East? Is it the, because the Eastern European? Is it the European? Is it the people from Ukraine? Is it them from Russia, from Poland, from Lithuania, all these European countries down there in the so-called state Israel? Or is it the Black people? So you're gonna have this massive debate, and a lot of people's eyes are going to be open. But obviously the wicked is going to try to squash it. So they may bring in World War III to squash it down. They may bring in another wicked deadly disease to squash it down, because they don't want the truth to be heard. But either way, it's going to come out anyway. But the Bible tells you, Yesaya says, I've always loved you. Always. Who is he talking about? He said, Hebrew, Yeshahelai, so Jews, I've always loved you. Never ever stopped loving you, though we went through so much. Still going through, lying. But he's always loved us as a people, as a bloodline people. He loves the church because he has created the church. He said to Peter, men say that I am? Peter said, you are the Christ, son of the living Ahaya. And Yesaya turned to him and said, Peter, listen to me. What you've just said is truth. Upon your confession, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. So we know that Yesaya has a church. Glory be to the Most High, because he's coming back for a church without spot, wrinkle, or blemish. But equally, he's got a bloodline people that he needs to save, that he needs to regather. This is what the church is not preaching, because they're telling you that he's already done the regathering in the 1948 state. That's them. It's not true. When you wake up and realize that they've been lying to us, brothers and sisters, you will know what time it is. So, Aaron, Kyrie is Aaron, working in the spirit of Aaron, and both him and Black Moses is going to come together. Ahaya has chosen this young man. His chosen, brothers and sisters. His work is big. It's huge. But he's going to do it. He'll be protected, and his family will be fine. Please send this video to him. I think he needs to see it. Because I don't follow them. I have to go search for him, isn't it? I have to go. I'll try to send it to him as well, if I can find him. Is he on Instagram or Twitter? I don't even remember my Twitter account, but I have to try to remember it, ain't it, really and truly. But send this video to him. The more people send it to him, I'm sure he will see it. But he is Aaron. Ahaya is waking up his people. And many people are not going to like it, but it's the truth. It's time, because at the ending of the day, what you don't understand, by the time the second Exodus approaches, people have got to understand why it's happening. It's just like ancient Yashahel, where the first Moses, where Moses, amen, where Moses was, you know, leading the people. But they knew why they were leaving Egypt, isn't it? They knew, and everybody went. And so therefore, the scattered tribe has to understand. The only difference with the scattered tribe, the only difference, well, it's not only difference, two difference really. Only two differences is that ancient Hebrew Yashahel in Moses' time, in ancient time, ancient Yashahel, they were in one location, Goshen. They were there. Second thing, they weren't mixed. They were, when they married in the tribe. Everybody, you can go marry the Judah and a Levi, or a Reuben and a Simeon, or a Gad and a Dan. You could marry, but now in 2022, this is where the problem is going to come in, because everybody's mixed. Like, but Ahaya knows his people. He knows them. And I've said it before, and I'm saying it again. The only, you know, I see other non-blacks on the cruise ship with us, because they're going to come. The church, the true church. Because the Bible tells you, the church said, the woman is a church. So we have true born-again child of the Most High, Ahaya, who are not Hebrew Yashahelites, but they love the Lord wholeheartedly. They're coming on them ship. They're going to be saved from the wicked, dirty destruction from the Antichrist. So we know that they're going to come. Some of them, not everybody. The majority of the people will be Yashahel. But some of our brothers and sisters in Christ, glory be, that love the Lord, is going to come with us. The Bible tells you the woman has 12 stars around her head. The 12 stars represent the 12 tribe. The 12 tribe fleeing into the wilderness. The woman is the church. But you cannot separate the church from Yashahel, because it's one and the same. Amen. Glory be to the Most High. So all these things are, so you see why the people have to wake up. So you have to wake up to understand judgment. You see, if the 3 days of darkness come tomorrow, many people won't understand why it happens. On part of the thing, you have to understand why certain things happen. Brothers and sisters, I'm looking at the time. Ooh. Okay, why certain things happen. So that's the reason why the tribes have to wake up. Ahaya is going to use people to wake them up. Not only Black Moses and Aaron, they're the prominent ones. Ahaya has chosen them, prominent ones. But it's a season.